musical style blues was the first type of music that really influenced Daniel Jolly into wanting to become a musician. Because of this, he really studied the music and figured that he might as well pick up an instrument, so he chose the bass guitar. His first bass guitar was a Fender Squire, and he really loved the feeling of playing and producing music itself, so he wanted to join a band of any kind just so that he could actually play with other people, not just practice by himself. He found that he was able to play at his school's worship team. Just playing with other people made him feel very good about himself, and he wanted to continue to play music with other people. In his search for music, he found a band, Audio Adrenaline. And he really enjoyed the band, and he followed them, just studying their music, and going to many shows, buying CDs, and just listening to them. He decided that he really would like to play music for a very, very long time, and it was almost like his calling. So he decided to come up with a band himself called Breaking the Silence. He was only a freshman at the time, but he really tagged on music well, and it was a three-man band, and he was the bassist and singer. He also wrote all the music and lyrics, and he acquired longtime friend Kyle Buckle on the guitar, and Patrick Jolly, his brother, on the drums. Unfortunately, about a year later, Breaking the Silence broke up. They all went different directions, and Daniel Jolly, he was not ready to give up music. He was a sophomore at the time, and he was kind of forced upon playing the guitar at his school's worship team. And he actually enjoyed the guitar a little bit more than the bass, so he started focusing on the guitar. After his decision to start playing the guitar, he started getting a little bit more into jazz guitarists such as Wes Montgomery, and this actually caused him to write more jazz-like music. Daniel never ceased to write music. He continued writing lyrics and really felt great about playing the guitar over the bass. He was influenced by so many different jazz artists such as Eric Clapton, John Mayer. And as much as he could, he continued to play with his brother and even his dad as they played multiple three-man shows involving worship music. So. And he still is writing music today, and he absolutely loves it.